Built in the 1950s, the Woodill Wildfire was the vision of one man, Robert Woodill. He was a car dealer who wanted to offer a lightweight, affordable sports car. Its revolutionary fiberglass design came from Glassbar, a boat-making company. Fiberglass was chosen because of its lightweight and low cost. Though only 9 Wildfires were made, they inspired a whole new generation of sports cars, and they became the predecessor to Chevy's Corvette. This is a 53 Woodill Wildfire. This is the most expensive car Gas Monkey's bought to date.
Oh,
the most expensive.
I was gonna ask you how much it was, but you know.
I don't wanna talk about how much this one was until I sell it.
All right.
But I got a stinking suspicion. I believe wholeheartedly that this is a six-figure car.
Yeah, I'd like to see that. I don't know about that one.
You watch and see. It's the first American fiberglass sports car. It predates the Vette. It was faster, lightweight.
Well, they were scared of chrome on this car or what?
It is a little just drab. The really cool thing about the car is that there just aren't any. I mean, you can't just go out and buy one.
It looks like a kit car to me.
I can tell Aaron's not super excited about this car, but the bottom line is, it's a cash cow as long as we don't mess it up. So we're gonna change the paint a little bit, drop down the windshield, do the interior, get rid of that stupid spare tire, and throw on some Dayton wire wheels. Then I'm gonna roll it across the block, and you know what? Gas Monkey just took some guy's pride and joy and made a ton of money. Be careful with everything on this car because it's gonna be hard to find.
All right, let's get started.
Let's do it.
We're having a tough time removing one of the windshield sanctions. The fact that the car's body's made of fiberglass doesn't make it very easy. I hate fiberglass. I hate messing with this. Fiberglass.
That should have moved up some.
Yeah, it did, about an eighth of an inch.
All right.
One crack or a break in this body and Richard's investment's gonna take a big hit. No pun intended.
It's up a little more.
All right, well, we're headed somewhere now.
Casey, did it come out?
Yeah, it made some weird noises
Yeah, I bet it did.
Good news. We dodged our first bullet. We got the windshield sanction post out. We can send the car over to Casey's paint shop and now Richard can chill out.
So we got the 53 Wildfire over to my paint shop. As soon as we're taped up and got it sanded, we're gonna lay down the paint. Richard and Aaron decided they wanted to paint the top black to break up all the white that's on the car. Pretty nice car already, so I think just adding the black top will make it look real classy. Painting on fiberglass can be tricky, but I got lucky on this one. The original paint was still in good shape, so after a light sanding and some black on the hood, the Wildfire's ready to go.
So one of my plans since I first saw the Wildfire was to get rid of those wheels. I wanted to stay authentic to the time period, so I ordered up a set of Dayton wire wheels. That adds my bling and hopefully my cash.
They really look good.
Yeah, they do.
Dayton did a hell of a job, dude.
I can't believe they got them out of the door this fast.
Dayton wire wheels have been around since 1916 and are famous for their knockoff wheel. That's a wheel with a single nut in the middle for quick and easy change. The Indy 500 cars of the 40s had them, and after World War I, Dayton even made airplane wheels. Even Charles Lindbergh had a set on the Spirit of St. Louis. The single nut design is also an authentic choice for today's lowriders and street rods.
I think there's a massive resurgence with it, and I think Dayton is exclusively to blame for the resurgence in spoke wheels.
They made exact duplicate, and they did it one-off immediately.
Well, I'm tickled to death. I'd like to see what they look like on the car.
Let's get them on.
Here pretty soon.
I want to drive this damn thing.
When I got the lead on this car, I gotta be honest, I had to look up and see what the heck it was. A company called Woodill. They only made 9 cars. This is one of those 9 cars, and it is damn cool.
Our vision for it was a little better than it was at the factory. We two-toned the paint job on it, then we shortened the windshield. We've reupholstered the seats, we've re-chromed the bumpers on it, and just detailed it, brought it back to life. But one of the best things is we got rid of the ugly wheels and put on a brand new set of Daytons. Really popped this car. We weren't sure what we were gonna find in the engine. You know what? We lucked out on this one. The motor was pretty clean, but it's been sitting for 20 years. So we gave it a tune-up, replaced the gas tank, cleaned the rocks out of the motor.
That's what this car's for, driving fast, having fun, and racing. I'm really excited about the Woodill because it's an expensive car. I had to step out of my comfort zone on this one. Gas Monkey just made its biggest bet, and you're gonna watch it pay off.
Or not.
So, check it out. 53 Woodill Wildfire. We put everything back stock. He had changed a couple of things, And this, of course, other than the battery, is the way it would have came from the factory.
I've collected early American sports cars for almost 28 years. And I'm like, there is no way that he owns that car and found that. I think it's cool you bought this car. Actually,
I think it's going to be even cooler if I can get you to buy it. What sold me on this car when I went to look at it was it's titled as a Woodill, not as a such and such homemade or whatever.
You're fixing to show me, which evidently you guys have looked.
Here you go.
Open the door, which is the first telltale sign. It's got a production tag. Serial number's right. I'm just like, oh, crap. I want that car. There's only two documented sales of these cars, and neither of those cars would probably tell you too much before we try to figure out
I've already seen the two documented sales. One just sold for $106. They had one on the lawn at Pebble Beach, and the one that was $106 wasn't a real car.
Yeah, none of those cars were a factory Woody Woodill built car.
I can smell your money already. You're going to buy it.
Man, it sounds good. Man, this thing is so cool. Sounds great, looks great. I had no idea that the quality of the car would be that good. I mean, wow. It runs like it drives like it fits like it. It's just fantastic riding that car.
Pretty cool, huh?
It is. It's very cool.
Test drive always works. I got you, Dennis. Pony up.
What do you want for it? You've done some research.
My research tells me that it's got to be six figures. I mean, I'm thinking even 125-ish. It's a real car. It's titled real. It's tagged real. It is real.
I don't disagree with you. It's a huge piece of American history. American sports cars are the most undervalued cars on the market, bar none. Your blue sky number is 125, but
that's where I'm at.
But you don't want to hold this car, do you?
This is one of the biggest cars I've stepped up on in a long time, and you know me, I get nervous when I got that much tied up in one car.
I'm going to make you an offer.
It better be cash.
I'll make you a cash offer, but it's going to be it. Charlie, bring me that.
Oh, he's bringing out the case. So the big dude steps out of the shadows and hands Dennis a silver briefcase. There better be cash in there because the deal's going down right now. Do I have to count them?
If you want to.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Man, I want that money, but I don't know if I'm giving up 25 grand.
I'll one-up it one time, and that's it. I will literally walk.
How are you going to one-up 100 grand in cash? Is that a $500 bill?
What are you looking for?
The strip, man.
Oh, whatever.
They didn't have those in 1934?
Nope. Yes or no?
Damn it, dude.
It's deal or no deal.
Exactly. You own it.
All right, cool. Thanks for calling me on it.
I don't think I've ever even held 100 grand
once. I hope you did good on it. I mean, this, I love the car. I mean, I'm in.
Gas monkey did good. And I got a $500 bill.
There you go.
You know what's cooler than that? It's a $1,000 bill.